generations like it. So when you speak about animation, there are a lot of subgenres to it.
一つは先ほどおっしゃったドラえもんやクレヨンしんちゃん、あるいは PVR が扱っているような、呪術廻戦とかそういう IP のものですよね。まあ漫画原作の IP もの、それがすごく今日本 のみならず世界中で人気です。
So I'm sure everybody here knows as well, but just for reference, you have of course Doraemon and Shin-chan that you mentioned, and then what Mr. Bisley mentioned that you have, you know, IP-based, like manga-based animes that PVR is curating very successfully. So you have these two categories to begin with.
ただスズメはそのような IP ではなくてオリジナルのアニメーションです。どちらかといえばスタジオジブリ作品、宮崎駿監督がずっとやってきたような映画のための、物語がスズメです。ですから、こういうその映画オリジナルのものがインドで成功するのかどうか僕は確信がないんですが、それはもう本当にこう PVR にお任せするしかないなと、逆にスズメは成功しそうかどうか逆に僕は聞いてみたいですね。
So it is actually the question should be better directed to Mr. Bisley, but I cannot say anything because Suzume is something that is completely different. It is not the Doraemon-based children's cartoon. It is also not an IP-based, manga-based cartoon. It is an original story. It's a narrative. It is a filmmaking-based, but it's made on the animation platform.So I think how it works really, I'll wait to hear from PVR.
Yeah, how do you think, Biji-san?
I think I have incredible expectations. And as I said, like the last few months have exceeded our expectations, you know, not in just in terms of box office numbers, clearly this mic is working better, but also in terms of the videos that I've seen,you know, of fans and patrons while they've been watching anime films. I mean, our sites across the country from small towns also, like Kota and Allahabad, have actually taken videos of, you know, people screaming and shouting when the movies start. And I was amazed by this kind of response to the film. And I have like incredible expectations of this one also come 21st of February.
At the same time, one more question from my side. India, हमारे देश में बहुत सारी ऐसी बातें हैं, ऐसी पौराणिक चीजें हैं, कथाएं हैं जो जापान की भी हिस्ट्री बहुत अच्छी है, उनका भी संस्कृति बहुत रिच है. क्या यहाँ की कोई कहानी इन्हें पसंद आई है? क्या वो सोचना चाहेंगे यहाँ की किसी कहानी को फिल्म में तब्दील करने का?
そうですね。その僕たちはたくさんの伝統行事のようなものこうインドからもらっていると思います。その例えば、僕たちは、まあ、お盆という習慣があって、まあ、夏に、先祖の霊が自分たちの家に帰ってくるというその、ねまあ、お盆という習慣があるんですけど、それは仏教から来ていますので、インドと、そういう、こうマインドを共有していると思います。
I think your question is really interesting because rather than thinking of it as Japanese culture or Indian stories, what I find is that we have a lot of much more commonality than we imagine. For example, in Japan you have something called Obon, and in India you have something called Pitrupaksha, which is exactly the same, that we think once a year our ancestors are going to come back, we need to welcome them, we need to appease them and send them back.And how beautiful it is that through Hinduism, through Buddhism, it has traveled to Japan. But we all feel the same way about our ancestors.
Arigato. Thank you.
One sec, before you, sir, one sec. There's another gentleman who's asked me, before you'll come in after him. Can you please give him a mic? No, here, sitting here. Hold on, one second, just hold on. This gentleman was number two in line. Okay, since you, 1 second, aapke paas aayega, you can ask your question first since you got it.
So my question is very simple. What made you choose this three-legged chair? Was it something related to the disaster, or was it something related to your childhood memory in your school kindergarten?
はい、鋭いですね。いくつかの理由があるんですが、一つは僕自身の子供時代の思い出です。確かにおっしゃる通りです。
I think you're a smart one, you got that out. Yes, so the first one is, yes, it's a childhood memory. I'm amazed that you guessed that.
僕が子供の頃、自分の父親が僕に椅子を作ってくれたんですね。本当にこの椅子のようなシンプルな糸を組み合わせただけの椅子でした。でもそれがとても嬉しかった。
So when I was a young boy, my father made a chair for me. It was a very simple chair, nothing too complicated, but it gave me so much happiness to know that it's my chair.
まあその時に思ったのはその自分の部屋をもらったような気持ちになったんです。あるいは自分の家を自分のお家をもらったような気持ちになりました。椅子というのは小さな子供にとって自分の最初の居場所だと思うんですよね。ですから、スズメの思い出のアイテムとして椅子がふさわしいなというふうに考えました。
So for a small child like me, for me to get my own chair, it was like having my own room, having my own house, because it is mine. It's the one thing that's only mine. And I wanted to keep that feeling intact somewhere. So that's why when I had to think of Suzume, I gave her a little chair that she could hold close to her heart.
そしてまあこの椅子を三本足にした理由は、まあこの映画全体のメッセージのシンボルとして、この椅子を三本足にしたかったんです。それは、まあ何か。力強く走らせて活躍させることはそういうメッセージなんというふうに考えました。
And the reason why it has three legs is because I think all of us have three legs in one way. Suzume, she's gone through a lot, she's feeling a lot. She's not complete, it's not perfect. But even without a perfect life, you can run happily on three legs, you can do a lot, you can do enough. That's the message of the film, and I hope I was able to convey it through this three-legged fellow.
Thank you for asking. Thank you.
Your next, so just one second, sorry, he was waiting in line. Your next, right after this.
Shinkai-san, ohayou gozaimasu.
Ah, ohayou gozaimasu.
I'm Siraj Sayed from filmfestivals.com. My question is, when you were a child, what was the type of cartoon character or comic characters that appealed to you? And as you have grown up, has your own taste
はい、わかりました。自分が小さな頃とおっしゃって最初に思い浮かんだのはドラえもんです。ドラえもんのテレビシリーズではなく、まあ、長編シリーズがあるんですよね。まあ、劇場のアニメーションになったりする、その、まあ、夏休みのひと夏の冒険をするような物語がとても好きで、まあ、その漫画をよく読んでいました。
Thank you for the question. Yes, so Doraemon, somebody had mentioned that name. So you have the serialized version on TV, but you also have a longer version. And there was one about his adventures in the summertime. I used to love that one a lot.
まあ自分の人生を変えたようなアニメーションでいうと、自分が12歳の時ですかね、中学1年生ぐらいの時に見た、宮崎駿監督の天空の城ラピュタ、キャスリン・ザ・スカイというアニメーションです。初めて自分のお金で映画館に行って、世の中にこんなに面白いものがあるんだと衝撃を受けました。まあ、それが自分がアニメーションに惹かれる最初のきっかけだったかもしれないです。
And if you ask about the one movie that changed my life in animation, it is of course Miyazaki Hayao's Castle in the Sky. I was a young boy, a school boy. I paid money myself to go watch the movie and I was blown away. I was like, this can be a way of life, this can be a way of art. It opened a new door in my mind.
まあ、大人になってから見て衝撃を受けたアニメーションというのはいくつかありますが、まあ、比較的最近でもないんですが、比較的大人になってからの作品でいうと「アナと雪の女王」ですかね、「フローズン」、まあ、ハリウッド、ピクサーのアニメーションにとても大きな衝撃を受けました。
And as a grown up, I'm proud to say that I was blown away by Pixar's Frozen. I really like that one.
例えば、あれはこうプリンセス、そうですね、そのプリンセスが王様に救われるという話ではない、とてもその、まあ、現代的なメッセージが映画の中にありましたし、それがかつ、前編こうギャグが挟まれていて、本当にこうエンターテインメントとして笑えるものになっていた、その語り方のその巧みさ、ストーリーを観客の心に届けるそのうまさにとても衝撃を受けました。
And the reason why I like it so much is because of the craft of the storytelling in that movie. You don't have a typical princess gets saved sort of a script there. It's a very modern interpretation of what a princess is supposed to be. But at the same time, it's very entertaining. It is not didactic. It has a lot of jokes. It really pulls you in as a story. So I think in terms of the techniques, the craft of storytelling, I think Frozen did a great job. I really liked it.
Thank you.
Thank you. All right, you're next.
Hi, Samir here from Movie Talkings. Hi, welcome to India, sir. So you're a very commercially successful director. Your film, your name was a critical acclaim. It was a huge blockbuster in Japan. And Suzume has also done a record-breaking business in the opening weekend. So now, how do you see that growth, in your films in Japan as well as in India? Because when it comes to Indian box office, we don't really talk about these numbers in media, about the foreign films except for Hollywood.
もう PVR 次第なのかなというふうに思
います。
Again, it should go to the wonderful gentleman next to me. The same question about whether collections can match the Bollywood movie, the Hollywood movies in India. Do you think Japanese anime can reach the same levels that?
Absolutely, because you know, in the English films, the business is only growing. You know, the English film box office numbers were a lot lower, but now we have a lot many more films that are breaching the 40 crore mark or the 50 crore mark, or even more. You know, these movies that have come out like Avatar and John Wick 4 recently, and that's also because English films have been releasing in this country for the last 50-60 years, so there is already a market that has developed over the years. And anime is very new. We just kind of discovered it. It was always there, but we as a company just discovered it, and it's only been in our release plans and release schedules in our last 9-10 months. And already the numbers are overwhelming. They are reaching, some movies are reaching 7 crores, 8 crores. And this is without any kind of marketing. It's just basically, you know, the box office numbers and the popularity that comes from Japan, you know, along with these movies and the fan base that already knows about these films. I mean, in this day and age of internet and social media, people already know that these movies are coming. So we're just actually just riding on that popularity and not even doing much to popularize and market these films. And if we can have the support of our directors and producers and do a lot more as far as marketing is concerned, I think these films have a huge potential to reach those English box office numbers.
So,
thank
you. Another question. Which is going to be a lot of people.
Because he did not answer, so let me ask another question. So there is an Indian sensation called RRR, which recently won Oscar and Golden Globe, and it has released in like in Japan, like in October, and it is still running. It is the highest grossing Indian film in, you know, in Japan. So just would like to know your reaction, because we don't have any people, you know, coming over here and praising our Indian films.
So this is Bahubali mo RRR mo 映画館 で 見ました.
Don't worry, it's not just RRR. I watched Bahubali as well, and I watched it on the big screen.
So this is まあ、今も RRR は現在も日本の劇場で公開中なんですけれども、まあ、見た時にやっぱりこう、あ、エンタメはこう、インドのエンタメはこう、こんな風に新しいものを見せてくれるんだと、まだハリウッドで見たことのない新しい形のエンターテインメントを見せてもらったという、そういう衝撃を受けました。
And I enjoyed it thoroughly because it's entertainment, but it's a new flavor of entertainment. Hollywood doesn't give what RRR can give. It's a very unique experience. I loved it.
インドの観客があのような映画を作らせているんだなというふうに感じました。友人やいろんな人と一緒に見ながら声を上げるための映画であるなというふうに思ったんですね。日本の映画というのは黙って見る映画です。ですから、こう随分成り立ちが違う、観客そのものが違うんだなというふうに感じました。
And one other thing that I realized is that I have to give a lot of respect to Indian directors, that they're taking the trouble to make films that you can enjoy with your friends. They want to make a movie where you can go with a bunch of friends, you can shout at the movie, you can enjoy it together. Japanese directors tend to make movies where you hide within yourself and watch it silently. So I get to learn a lot from my Indian friends.
そうですね。僕はインドの映画の見方の方が、インドの皆さんのように笑いながら声を上げながら映画を見て、くれる。日本の観客が声を出してしまうような映画を作りたいと RRR を見ながら感じました。
When I watched RRR, I was like, someday I want to make a movie which will make Japanese viewers become Indian viewers. Well, they'll be able to come with a bunch of friends and shout out yay to a movie.
Thank you for asking.
Yes, we look forward to that. Yeah.
Abby.
You wanted to ask a question? Okay. Yeah.
Hello. Yeah. Shikai.
Hi.
Welcome to India. Welcome to Bollywood. Yeah. My question to you is, what inspired you to make this movie? Suzumi. Is there any memories behind it or something like you have something in mind? Like?
No offense, but he already answered that question already.
No problem. そうですね。最初にお答えしたように、一つは12年前に起きた実際の東日本大震災。まあ、もう一つは日本でその、まあ、人口減少も含めて廃墟が増えているということがまずありました。
So, but yeah, just to answer it then, one is about, you know, 12 years ago we had a really serious earthquake and tsunami in Japan. It created like huge tragedies. So I wanted to kind of capture that essence. And the second is the rise of abandoned buildings around Japan. I wanted to weave a story around that phenomenon.
ただもっと言えば日常を取り戻す物語を作りたいというふうに思いました。なぜなら災害というのは日常を、まあ、途中でね途切れさせてしまう出来事だからです。途切れた日常を取り戻す物語を作りたいと思ったんです。
But I wanted most of all for my movie to have a sort of a motif where you're able to reclaim normalcy because I think what a lot of us have lost with tragedies orDisplacement is what we consider normal or everyday. So somehow I wanted to show that it's possible to bring back what is normal and familiar to you.
そのために、必要なシンボルだなと思ったのがドアなんです。まあ説明が、ドアをね何度も開けたり閉めたりしますけど、ドアが日常のシンボルになると思いました。なぜなら僕たちは毎朝家起きてドアを開けて出て行ってドアを閉めて帰ってきますよね。そのドアの開け閉めの繰り返しが僕たちの日常だからこそ。日常だからです。
So one symbol of that is the door. So the door is used extensively in the movie. So what does the door mean? You open the door and it's your home. That is your place to be. And you shut the door and the rest of the world is out. So I was trying to show that, that it's possible to have that home.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We have time for two more questions. So one's from here. In order. Okay. Let him finish this.
So my first question is, romance has been an integral part of your movies since the beginning of your career. And however, it's not a straightforward romance. There's a hint of pain and it is mostly unrequited love. So is there a particular reason why you included it in your movies? Is this because you experienced something similar in your personal life?
あそうですね、まあ、おっしゃる通り特に僕の初期の作品だと、まあ、アンハッピーエンドのこう初恋が実らないような映画を繰り返し作ってきました。
You're actually right. In the beginning of my career, I made a lot of movies where there's unrequited first love.
まあその理由は僕自身がね初恋が実らなかったということもありますけれども、でも多くの人にとって初恋は実らないものだからと考えたからです。
That's because I myself had that experience, and I would like to believe a lot other people have that too. This is like what I'd like to believe.
ただまあ、そうですね。東日本大震災が起きる前までは、僕はそういうその初恋をめぐる物語を書いていたんですけど、ただ災害が起きてからは、もう少しそのそうですね、ラブストーリーからだんだん離れてきているような気がします。今回のスズメはどちらかといえばラブストーリーではなくて、スズメの成長物語です。
But you know, I myself changed as a person when I saw the scale of tragedy with the Tohoku earthquake. So I think it changed me as a person. It changed me as a filmmaker. So that reflected in Suzume as well. It's not a love story. It's more of a growth arc. It's about a girl who learns to find herself.
まあそのような映画を作っているのは僕たちの今の世界が災害に囲まれていると感じるからです。日本は地震もそうですけど、地震に限らずパンデミックもそうですよね。ロシア・ウクライナ戦争もそうだし、クライメートクライシス、気候危機もそうですよね。そんな風に災害が増えている世界の中で今作る映画としては、まあファーストラブの物語というよりはこのタフな世界の中でどうやって希望をつかむか、そういう物語を作りたいと思って今回のスズメは、まあ、今回のような物語になりました。
So Suzume kind of reflects that because I have this sense that we're perpetually living on the brink of crisis. You have climate change issues that are creating havoc across many countries. You have, Japan is in a seismic zone, you have a lot of earthquakes. When you don't have that, then of course you have Russia and you know, Ukraine just doing what they're doing. So what I feel is that we always are in a brink of something disastrous happening.But within that, we need to find hope. So I wanted to create a story about finding hope in a time of crisis.
またね、ファーストラブのことだけをテーマにしたような物語を作れるような平和な世界が戻ってくることを願っております。
But I have to say, it would be a very nice world if we were able to believe that we can only make movies about first love and then getting recruited. Right now, I feel that the world is in a much tougher space.
God willing. We have time for more questions. Don't worry. Lady in the sunglasses behind.
Hello? Sensei.
Hi.
インドへようこそ。
ありがとう。どこですか。手を挙げてなって。ああ、はいはい、はい、はい、はい、はい。
先生、インドへようこそ。
ありがとう。Thank you so much。
私に関しては、先生の映画は素晴らしいです。 私はインド人の漫画家です。そしてあの他のそのようなあの学生、そして漫画家になりたいそのような学生たちには何のアドバイスをあげますか？
わかりました。I think you have to say in English.
I basically asked him for the other artists who are wanting to make movies like so, what kind of advice would he give for the artists? 特にあのどうやって早く描けますか？
わかりました。どうやって早く描けるかどうかはもうひたすら、ね、数を重ねていくしかないんじゃないかなと思いますけど。
I wish I had an easy answer, but you just have to get on with it. You just have to work on it a lot to get speed.
でもあの今日とても幸せだなと思うのは、インドで漫画を描いているインドの漫画家の方に直接会うことができたのは僕は人生で初めてです。あのとても嬉しいです。
But I have to say, I don't think I'll forget you. The first time in my life to meet an Indian manga artist here in India. That's an amazing feeling for me. I'm very happy.
あのまあ、何かアドバイスできるとしたらそのきっと今とてもまだお若いと思うんですけど、その今の若い時の、気持ち、例えば焦りであったりとか、まだ思うような作品が描けないようなその、まあ、もどかしさや焦りという、その感情をずっと覚えていてほしいと思うんですね。そのもっと上手くなりたい、もっと早く描きたいというその気持ちが多分、自分を前に進めてくれると思います。
But if I had to give you advice, I won't give you technical advice. I'll tell you what works. You would never forget this feeling that you have right now. You asked a wonderful question. You said, how do I do it faster? So always remember this version of yourself. You're young, you're full of hope, you want to get things done, you want to get things done in a hurry. It's a wonderful quality to have. So I hope you never lose it. All the best.
Arigato.
I'll write it. Thank you. We have a question for Mr. Bijli right at the back.
Okay. Over here. With you. Take the mic.
First of all, we are waiting with bated breath for the movie Shikai-san, and thank you for your explanation. It is as exciting as the trailer that we saw. And my question now is to Mr. Bijli, you know, what are your expectations from the film, from box office performance? It's been grossing record levels across the world. And how do you see this category growing in India now?
As I said earlier, I think the numbers have been quite overwhelming ever since we started this division. We've been doing, you know, numbers in the range of $500,000 to $1 million gross box office, and we're expecting a lot more from this film. At least 10 crores gross box office across 250 screens. This is the first time we've actually dubbing it in Hindi as well. And you know, I feel that with the number of films that we're releasing in this category, in this genre, we're looking roughly at almost ending the year with about 30-32 crore kind of a business. And this is just the tip of the iceberg, as I said, because we've just started. There's a lot more we can do in terms of awareness and promotions and marketing. And I'm very confident that this segment will grow even further year on year.
Are you only dubbing it in Hindi or in other regional languages as well?
This one is only in Hindi, yes, yeah.
Next one will be in other. I heard you guys say that.
Yeah.
All right, one last question to the lady who's filming. Can some, take my mic.
As you mentioned that your film is in Hindi only, and Hindi films don't get compared without the music and dance. So just, what is the process of music? In case you have a dance
so, そうですね、そのスズメの中にはダンスシーンはないので、あのインドの観客に楽しんでもらえるか、ちょっとそこが不安でもありますね。
Thanks a lot. Now you got me worried that I don't have a dance scene in the Hindi version. How's it going to work?
ただまあ音楽に関しては、そのこの映画作りの初期の段階からとても深いレベルで、音楽の作曲家、まあ、ナットインビスというロックバンドと、コラボレーションしています。
But I'm glad you asked about the music because I know music is such an integral part of Indian movies. And I had a long collaboration with a rock band called Radwimps. We have worked on a lot of works together, and right from the beginning, they have worked very, very closely on Suzume with me.
脚本を書き終わった直後に、まず最初に書き終えた脚本を、まあ、ダッドインプスにロックバンドに送るんですね。で、彼らがその脚本を読んで、映画の感想を 歌の形で返してきてくれました。
And I'll tell you a very interesting story. Once I'm done with the script, the first people that I share the script with is Radwimps. And they give me feedback. And they don't give me feedback in terms of like emails or anything. They send it back in form of music. So they interpret my script into their music and they send it back.
そうですね。その歌はですから映画で使う曲じゃないんですね。まだ映画の映像ができていませんから、感想音楽として送ってきてくれて、でその歌のタイトルが玉木というタイトルだったんですね。スズメではなくて、スズメを育てているおばさんの名前がタイトルでした。
So an interesting story about what happened in Suzume is that once I send them the script, they send back songs. That song is not featured in the film. Imagine the storyboard isn't even put together. They just send out a song, and the song was titled Tamaki. Now the movie is about Suzume, but the song that they sent back was not about Suzume, the main character. It was about the lady who's worked hard to raise her as a single mother, Tamaki.
ですね、そのタマキは主役ではないのに、でもとても大事なキャラクターなんだというのが、その歌を聞いて僕は気づいたんですね。その歌の歌詞は、まあ、あなたが嫌いだったという言葉から始まるんですけれども、やっぱりこう孤児となった、災害孤児となってしまったスズメを引き取って、一人のシングルマザーが、ね、そのスズメを育てるにはとてもこういろんな気持ちのこう葛藤があったんだなということを、その歌によって僕は気づくことができたんです。
So I had been focusing on Suzume because she was the main character. But what was beautiful in the feedback in the song that they sent was that they looked at things from the point of view of this aunt who took in a small child who's been orphaned by an earthquake. And the title of the song begins by saying that I used to hate you at one time. And then it goes, the entire song revolves around how she grew into taking care of this young child, what all happened to herself.In order to become a mother to a young child.
その歌を聴くことで脚本も修正して、その修正した脚本を読んで彼らはまた曲を作ってくれた、まあ、そんな繰り返しで、だんだん映画に使う音楽になっていったんですね。
So what happened with that is that it made me realize that there are nuances that I should add to Tamaki's character. So I built that into the script and I shared it again with them. So the music actually takes the story forward in a very important way.
インドの映画を見ても、音楽というのは映画の中でとても大事な役割を果たしています。インド映画のようなダンスシーンを僕たちの、作品ではなかなか使うことはできないけれど、でもやっぱり僕たちにしかできないような音楽の使い方をしたいと思って、そのような、まあ、チャレンジをしています。
And I love your question because it points to a really important fact. It shows that music is really important to Indian movies and as well as to my movies in Japan. But in India, the songs are interpreted in terms of dance.But we don't have a scene where we can depict dance. But I think the way the music is very important, similarly important in my movies, and it carries the story forward in a different way. But music being a common denominator.
Thank you.
All right, we do have really one last question. The ushers have identified them. Could you? Okay, that's the last one. Thank you so much all for being here. Last question.
Hi, Sensei.
Hi, Sensei. Sensei.
First of all, welcome to India once again. And thanks to you and Piga Pictures for all, from all Indian anime fans. We all here are anime creatives from India, and we generally talk about anime in Hindi. So I will say this in Hindi. 2019 tak ye ek bahut bada sapna tha ki hum ek anime movie ko kabhi theater mein dekh payenge. And it was all thanks to Piga Pictures, jo 2019 mein Devious Broly movie ko India mein leke aaye. And now not only a Makoto Shinkai movie is coming to India, but the legend himself is here. So this is like more than a dream come true thing. So hum sabhi anime fans ki taraf se, first of all, a huge, huge, huge thanks to you. India is a very diverse country, and we can see people, all Indian anime fans, they are from different places, different traditions, different culture. And now anime has also become a platform where we can connect to each other.So, India में ऐसे बहुत सारे portions हैं जो internet में हैं, जो अभी घर में बैठ के आपको देखेंगे, जो आपकी movie का कब से wait कर रहे हैं, since Tenki No Ko. So, आप उनके लिए क्या कहना चाहेंगे? What message would you like to give to all Indian anime fans, to Indian anime community?
はい、わかりました。そうですね、その僕の育った町も日本の本当に田舎だったので、映画館はありませんでした。近くの映画館が電車を乗り継いで2時間かかる場所でした。
I really feel what you're saying. You know, when I was a young boy, I used to live in a place that didn't have a movie theater. You had to go 2 hours by train to reach the closest theater. So I know what you're talking about.
そうですね、その、なんだろう、僕が映画を作っていて、一番の喜びは、自分がこう、生きていて、一生会うことがないであろう人たちとも、映画を通じてコミュニケーションができることなんですね。見たことのない人たち、自分とは全然違う国に住んでいる人たち、自分と全く違う人生の人に、映画を通じて、なんだか会話ができる、それが一番の、喜びですので、ですので、そういうこうインドのね、すごく田舎の映画館がないような場所に住んでいる人、何らかの形でインターネットを通じてでも僕の作品を見て、何かを感じていただけたのであれば、本当にこれ以上の幸せはないです。
As a filmmaker, I'm so happy to be meeting all of you here in person. But, as a filmmaker, what it means to me is that.There are people whom I haven't met. There are people whom I'll never be able to meet. There are people with whom I don't share a common language or a geography. But we are connected through my movies. It is a sort of a magic to me. So if you're saying that there are young people with internet connectivity, that they'll be able to see my movie, it'll bring them joy. Nothing brings me bigger happiness than to know that. Thank you for that.
Thank you.
Thank you. Arigatou gozaimasu.
Arigatou gozaimasu.
Which I'm going to request you to step off the podium. We'd like a photo of the two of you, the press, please.
Oh, hi.
In cultural ties between India and Japan. Thank you so much for enlightening us, for your answers, for giving us your time. It has been unreal, and I know all of you have had a great time. All your fans in India are waiting for Susan May to hit the theatres this Friday and be transported into the magical world you create with every vision of yours. Arigatou gozaimasu, and have a great day ahead of you.
Thank you so much. ありがとう。ありがとうございました。
Thank you.